goodness gracious, let me tell you the news. My head's been wet with the midnight dew. I've been down on bended knee, talking to the man from Galilee. He spoke to me with a voice so sweet, I thought I heard the shuffle of angels too. He called my name and my heart stood still when he said, John, go do my will. Go tell that long-tongued liar, go and tell that midnight rider, tell the rambler, the gambler, the backbiter, tell him that God's gonna cut him down. Tell him that God's gonna cut him down. You can run on for a long time, run on for a long time, run on for a long time. Sooner or later, gotta cut you down. Sooner or later, gotta cut you down.
What's up, guys? Long time no see, long time no talk. My name is Skidell Johnson. For those who don't know me, I was a former Navy diver in the U.S. Navy, and I got some questions from some future people trying to attend dive school from our previous YouTube video. They're asking for helpful advice as to what to expect in prep and dive school and what you should work on the most. What else? There's another guy who contacted me about him being a commercial diver and whether that would help him going through dive school. We're just going to touch on some topics. So starting from dive prep, that's where most of the weeding out is going to be. I'm not going to give you guys every detail because then you'd know, I don't know, kind of still want you guys to earn it and go through the hardships instead of it all being force-fed to you. But prep, basically, get ready to get your ass smashed and get weeded out of the most. If you're a woman, don't expect anything to be any easier for you because you are a woman. You're most likely gonna get hounded on even more, so it's kind of like proving yourself more of your worthiness. Because I mean, I've worked with women out in the fleet, and it's unfortunate that you do have to pick up some of their slack, whether they're going through their menstrual or whatnot. You know what I'm getting at. But yeah, prep, you're going to do a lot of log PT, a lot of finning work, so, and a lot of treading. So make sure your ankles are comfortable with finning. With fins, you can go to Walmart and buy some fins. That's what I did before I joined the Navy. They have like US diver fins, whatever. It's a whole kit, snorkel, mask, fins, and a mesh bag. You can go out and buy one of those. It's probably like $20 still, pretty cheap. And then if you're just getting in the water, I suggest trying to work up to a 500 yard swim without fins. And then once you're comfortable with 500-yard swims for time, I would start finning exercises, because by that time your body's conditioned and ready to take on that, versus just hopping in it and possibly getting an ankle injury or any kind of injury. So that's about finning. Then there's treading. So the number one thing that gets guys kicked out of prep is the final evolution, which is consisting of basically treading with, it was the equivalent to like 80 pounds. Now, you don't need to be out there treading with 80 pounds or anything like that to get prepared for what you're going to face for your final great evolution. What you should be doing and what you can do is the pools that are local to most of you guys have these 5 or 10 pound bricks, and you need to get comfortable with treading with that in your hand out of the water, arms all the way extended out of the water, and for time. So you can start for 30 second intervals, or and then work your way up to a minute interval. Eventually you're gonna have to get up to about, what is it, like a, it's like a 5 minute, 6 minute evolution, depending how good you and your dive buddy work together. When you get to school, they'll explain everything else to you. I'm not going to give you all of that information, but It's all about you and your buddy working together and putting out. And don't forget to put out, because if you don't put out, you're just gonna get hounded more. You're gonna get more tired. You still have to do the same evolutions over again. And that makes its way, unless you have a not quitting mindset already, which you should if you're going to these programs, these special programs. So the next thing, let's see. So the guy that was talking about, he's a commercial diver, going to dive school, and whether or not that would help him. In a certain way, yes, because you're already familiar with diving, but everyone knows for the most part that Navy diving and commercial diving are two different diving worlds. Our rules and their rules are totally different. From what I've learned, the commercial diving is more of the wild, wild west cowboy style. I mean, we're still fucking pirates and cowboys, we're all divers, but the rules and things you learn are totally different. The equipment you use is totally different. How your what do they call it? Your bailout bottle, we call it an EGS. How just one's facing down, one's facing up, it's just totally different rules. So in that aspect, yes, you will be familiar with diving, but not with Navy diving, and your instructors most likely will not give a shit if you are a commercial diver trying to become a Navy diver. You still have to prove yourself, as is anybody else. I mean, there's guys that made it through dive school trying to go through another special program pipeline, EOD, or there's a DMT guy when I was going through, who goes through the same selection as us. He was a fleet returnee, and he was going through the EOD pipeline, and he quit in the middle of his training. This is training that he's already been through. They do less diving when they get to dive school for the EOD pipeline. Their time there is shorter than what you go through as a DMT. So it was quite surprising, but I mean, it's a special program for a reason. So don't expect any special treatment just because you're a commercial diver going to dive school. No one really cares. Put out and do good on your tests, and you'll be fine. Trying to find other things other people were asking about. So backtracking to the commercial diving guy, he was wondering how he would approach a recruiter with that information. You just go to the recruiter as any other guy would, tell him you want to be a diver. You'll start training to earn your contract, and whenever you earn your contract, you'll get a ship out date, and then you start going through the pipeline. So another question from Kirkalicious was, or statement slash question, he's like, I'd like to hear about your experience with how you chose to be a Navy diver and what the process was like. How I chose to be a diver was, I originally started my career out as a gunner's mate. I went through the gunner's mate pipeline, realized while I was in school, like, this is not what I wanted to do. There was multiple times in boot camp that the special programs recruiters would flush guys in to put a video on to show guys that might have not known what it was. You get what I'm saying. You're going through boot camp and they put you in this room, they put everybody in this room to see who it might be interested in special programs. They put on this video, that motivational cool guy video with all the guys doing the cool work, and then they ask who wants to do this, and then they take you from your division that you're already in boot camp and put you into the 800 divisions, and then you basically break off from your normal boot camp and go straight into earning your selection. But my choice and how I chose to become one was, like I said, I was a gunner's mate. I got to my first command. I don't know how it worked out. I got sent to a explosive ordnance disposal command, and they stuck me in a platoon full of NDs, full of Navy divers. There was about the billet itself You needed to go to combat school and go to dive school, but that was only for scuba at the time, and to fill that billet. So when I got there, you know, they beat the shit out of me to get me prepared for dive school. Before I even got there, I went through combat school. And then I got there after dive school, I graduated, whatever. I got there and I started doing work with these guys, working with these guys for a couple of years. And then that was kind of like the inside of what it was like to be a Navy diver. So I was like, hell yeah, I want to do this. So I got my ass handed to me for a couple more years and eventually got my chance to go to dive school. And I made it. I was honor man. I mean, I was the best prep, I think, because of my experience. And yeah, that was mostly why I chose to become a Navy diver. The process for me wasn't that hard because I was already surrounded by it so much throughout my career, and the guys actually put in a lot of effort in training me and helping me, so it wasn't that hard for me. I had rough days in dive school, don't get me wrong. I mean, you're waking up at 5 o'clock or earlier, depending on who your instructor is, to get your ass handed to you. So let's see what other questions do you guys have. What I should work on the most, blah, 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 blah. Finning. I hate the smell of cigarettes, sorry, I guess. Finning. What else? You're gonna do a lot of book work at dive school. But you'll have ample time to study after class. There are some days where it's night studies because there's so much information they're force feeding you, and you have to retain it because there's a certain threshold that if you don't get a certain percentage on each test, you have a possibility of flunking out of the selection, no matter how many push-ups you can do or how good you are in the water. Let's see what else. How long does it take to become a Navy diver? It takes about 6 months total. You spend 2 months in prep, or 2.5 months in prep. That's skipping the boot camp phases you go through. So that's like 2-3 months. I forgot how long boot camp was. It's been so long ago. Then into prep, 2 months. So that's already what, almost 4 months. Then after that, if you get the golden ticket to dive school, dive school was what? 4 months? 4.5 months, something like that. 120 some days. Yeah. So the whole process should take you about 8 months roughly if you're starting fresh. And if you don't get rolled back, or if you don't get, yeah, if you don't get rolled back or injured or whatever. That's basically all the advice and tips I have for you guys. Tread with, get in the water, get comfortable in the water, start swimming, number one. Get your ankles comfortable with treading with the fins. Treading with weight. Now, you don't need to be in the pool with 30-pound weight vests, although you could, but don't kill yourself. Just get comfortable with treading with a 10-pound brick above your head for about like 5 minutes with fins. That's after a workout. Get comfortable with doing serpentine swimming thousands of yards. When I say thousands, I mean, if you're comfortable swimming with 2,000 yards without fins, should be good to go. You're going to be swimming a lot more than that. And I guess the number one rule while you're in school is, for me personally, is take care of you guys. Even when you're outside of school, after you make it, never leave your dive buddy. Um, And yeah, just take care of each other, man. Don't be selfish going through this program, thinking it's me. Nah, man. You take care of you guys. There's one time the old CEO came out and gathered, he gathered up everybody at dive school and had this, you know, this pep talk with everybody at the schoolhouse. He brought the recon and Air Force and NDs and scuba and EOD divers all around. And one morning after PT, it's after the TO's challenge, you know, he explained to us a lot of things. But one thing he did explain was, that stuck with me, was, you know, it's not just a job, it is a lifestyle. And don't forget that, protect that. Don't let it just turn into a selfish job, because we need each other out there. There's less of us than there are frogs out there, you know. Take care of each other, man. So if you guys have any more questions, don't be afraid to drop a comment in this video and let me know what else you want to chat about. Prepare for the suck and embrace the suck. Take care, guys. Peace. My life be like, wow.